Good morning, once again, and welcome to our class. Today we are going to start on something new. We are going to look at the process of strategic management in purchasing and supplies, the process of strategy. Strategic management in purchasing and supplies. That's what we are going to look at today. But before we go there, I want us to finish up something we had started last week. Last week we started something that we did not conclude. I want us to look at the factors in strategy selection. Now, before we go to the main steps in implementing a strategy, I'm sharing my screen. You can see the notes there on the screen. We have a diagram there. You can see how strategic supply chain management influences our organizations. You can see number one, the enterprise policies, goals, and strategies. Now, this is our organization's strategic direction, which influences the business processes. The key element here is business processes. Business processes is influenced by three factors: our organization's policies, strategies, and goals. Then we have what to call business enablers, the human resources, IT, and then we have the environment, what to call the enterprise framework. All these are factors that influence the strategic direction of an organization. These three factors, organization policies, strategies, and goals, and the business enablers, plus the enterprise framework and environment, they influence the business processes in an organization to give us results now, higher profits. A company will only get higher profits if it takes care of these three processes that affect the organization's business processes. Operational processes of the organization, the operational processes of the company, and the day-to-day organization operational activities. Are you doing manufacturing? As an organization, you might be doing manufacturing. So in our day-to-day running and operation of the organization, what do we do? To convert the raw materials into the finished products, what processes and activities do we engage? And now, when we bring on board the concept of strategic supply chain management, at the bottom, from the bottom up to the top. Now, the top we have the enterprise policies, goals, and strategies, which should be aligned towards the strategic direction of the company in the area of supply chain management. Then in our organization, we shall see results, higher returns. We shall see achieve higher results and higher returns. That is what we call the factors in strategy selection. Now let us go to now something new. There we were just concluding what we were doing last week. Now let us go to something totally new. What we call the process of strategic management. You can see that diagram there. We are going to look at the process that involves the implementation of strategic concepts in an organization. You might be the head of department somewhere in a company. You are the head of department, procurement department. You are the director, the manager. And you are tasked with the responsibility of coming up with the strategic direction for your company. What will this involve? What will this involve? This is what we are going to look at today. This will be our concern today. Number one, let us first of all list the processes. You can see we have strategy analysis and planning. Then we have strategy formulation and strategic decision making, strategy choice, then strategy evaluation. And then at the end, we have what we call a strategy evaluation. Strategy evaluation. This is where we measure. Is what we plan to do working? And is it giving us the desired results? At the very beginning, we had our objectives, we had planned something. This is what we wanted to do as an organization. This is what we wanted to achieve. Now, are we there? Or we have lost our track? Let us start with the first one. Strategy, analysis, and planning, the first step. Now, strategy, analysis, and planning. As an organization, here we start with scanning our environment. We do something we call scanning the environment. We first of all look around us. What is affecting us? That is why last time we were looking at pesto. You remember? There's a lesson we looked at pesto, SWOT. We look at where we are and what is affecting us. We have created a WhatsApp group. Now, can you join our group using the link? On the chat, we have a link. This is Damaris and Anne Wairia. We have created a WhatsApp group. Join our WhatsApp group using that link on our chat. We need a group for the purposes of communication. So here we start by looking around us. How are we performing as an organization? What is affecting us internally and externally? That is the first thing we look at, scanning. Environmental analysis, we call this strategic analysis. We forecast what is affecting us. So that now we can come up with a roadmap. Now the next part, we call it planning. After we know where we are, we now plan on what we want to do and how we want to get there. This is what we call planning. And we look for appropriate resources to enable us to do that. Then we do something else we call strategy formulation. We do strategy formulation. This is where we plan and do decision making involved in developing organizations' strategic goals and plans. This is where now we come up with our organization's goals and objectives to respond to our analysis. Remember, we started with strategic analysis. Once now we know what we need and what is affecting us, Now we come up with now the strategic plan of the company. And it should be influenced by a time scale, or what you call a time horizon. Our strategy formulation should be time bound. We want to do something for how long? We want to do something. We want to achieve something for how long? The plans we come up with should be influenced by a time factor, so that we can be able to track our progress. We need to factor in the element of time. For most organizations, most strategic plans cover at least 5 years. Most strategic plans cover at least 5 years. That is the trend. Good morning, Richard. Richard, can you hear me? Okay, welcome to class. And join our WhatsApp group using the link above there. On the chat, we have a link for our WhatsApp group. Join the group using that link. Then once we come up with a strategic plan, now we go to the next step. What we call a strategy implementation. Strategy implementation. This is where we execute the strategic plans. Remember, we have come up with a very good plan on what we want to do and how we want to do it. Now, next, we come up with how to execute the plans. Now, this is the action itself, implementing what we had planned to implement. This is what we call a strategy implementation. We come up with administrative tasks. We assign responsibilities. This is where we assign responsibilities to various persons so that they can perform what we wanted them to perform. We come up with a system. Strategy implementation involves coming up with a system that will ensure that our strategic plan has been implemented in our operational processes. Our operational processes. The day-to-day running of the business. Remember, for the strategy to work, the strategy involves implementing little bits and bits of information here and there, small steps here and there that contribute to the success of the entire organization as a whole. That is what we call operational processes. As the top executives of the company, we shall come up with a system by choosing the right team. We come up with the right team, choose and appoint the right people who will help us come up with our strategic plans. Implementation of this process is very important. So we choose the right people, the right supervisors. We choose a team of the right supervisors who will help us implement what we planned on paper. Remember, our plans are printed on pen and paper, and they will not help the company if we don't put that now into tangible aspects that can be tracked. The team we choose, the administrative team we choose, they will coordinate now the employees below them. The executive team we select, the leaders we elect and appoint, they will coordinate, control, and direct now the employees below them to implement the rest of the plan so that now it can work. And how will this be merged into our day-to-day operational processes? All departments in our organization will be involved. We say all employees from top to bottom, from bottom to top, all employees should understand the strategic plan of the company. The strategic management concept will not work if everybody in the company is not aware of what we want to do and achieve as a company. Success will only come if we make sure that everybody in the entire company is aware of our strategic plan and the strategic direction. So we choose the right leaders to coordinate and control the actual execution of our strategic plans. And that is not all. We also need to motivate the leaders as well as the members involved in strategic implementation. These leaders should be fully motivated. We need to come up with appropriate motivation mechanisms to ensure that our team members and the leaders have the morale to implement our strategic plan. That is what we call a strategy implementation. So we have looked at strategic analysis and planning, strategic formulation, and strategy implementation. Let us now go to the next last step, what we call strategy evaluation. Our last thing is now strategy evaluation. This is the last step, strategy evaluation. It is not going to work. You cannot be working hard, and we are not measuring whether you are making any progress. If you work without measuring whether you are making any progress, you will not gain anything. You will even lose track. You deviate from what you should be doing. You lose track and you will not know it. And at the end of the period, you will not have achieved anything and you will not have achieved your objectives. So now the last part is what we call strategy evaluation, performance evaluation, and the feedback process. This is where we measure the progress we are making to determine whether we are on the right track or we are losing. We want to go north. Is everybody going north or we are going north, where some people are going northeast, others are going northwest, wengine wanaenda south. The purpose of strategic evaluation is to determine whether what we plan to implement, has it been implemented, is it working, and is it giving us the right results. This draws light on the efficiency and effectiveness of the comprehensive plans in achieving the desired results. What is the efficiency and effectiveness of our comprehensive plan in achieving the desired results? Remember, we started by coming up with objectives, the goal of the company, the vision, the mission, and the objectives. Are those vision and mission objectives helping us as a company to achieve our results, our desired results? Like now, higher profits. You can see that diagram. One of our results might be higher profits. Are we actually achieving the higher profits? Remember how we looked at it. A company can come up with objectives like increase in profits, increase in market share, increase in customer satisfaction, cost reduction. Those can be our objectives. And now, to achieve those objectives, we come up with a plan that involves indicators. We have objectives. Then we come up with indicators that will help us to measure if what we plan to achieve is actually working. The indicators. We want to increase profits. How do you measure if profits are increasing? And then we need what we call action plans. What do we need to do to increase the profits? So now at the end of the day, we want to measure if actually it is working. Is what we planned to do working? Or we are lost? That is what we call strategy evaluation in purchasing and supplies. We call that strategy evaluation in purchasing and supplies. The managers can also assess the appropriateness of the current strategy in today's dynamic world with the socio-economic, political, and technological innovations. As purchasing managers, when we come up with strategic plans for our purchasing department, we need to measure if what we have is sweetened to the current economic environment. As a company, sometimes you can have a strategic plan that is outdated. Sometimes our strategic plans are outdated. So we need to make sure that our strategic plans are flexible and able to respond to the changes happening in our economic environment, political environment, and technological environments. Why do we need strategy evaluation? Why do we need strategy evaluation? Let us look at that. Number one, strategy evaluation helps us to do appraisal. It helps us to come up with appraisal and reward systems. Remember, we only want to reward the employees that are performing. We want to reward the employees that are meeting the targets. We want to give back to the employees that are helping the company to grow. So strategy evaluation helps us to measure the departments that are performing and the employees that are performing, so that those who are not performing, action can be taken against them. That is one importance of strategy evaluation. It also helps us to judge the validity of our strategic choices. Strategy evaluation helps us to judge the validity of our strategic choices. Are our objectives valid and useful? Validity, here we look at the usefulness of our objectives to help us achieve our goals. Sometimes as organizations, we might come up with objectives that will not add value to our organization's success. And we will never know that. We will never find out that unless we measure. We can only get to know that if we measure. Are our objectives credible and valid? Now, evaluation helps us to determine that. Another importance of strategy evaluation is that it provides a means of feedback. Strategy evaluation helps to develop a means of feedback so that now employees can communicate back to the top executives on the progress being made while implementing our strategies. Feedback all the way from the bottom all the way to the top. We said we wanted to cut costs. How are the employees at the bottom helping us to cut the costs? How are the employees at the bottom helping us to increase profits, increase quality, increase customer satisfaction? Is it working, or what are the challenges of our strategies? That is now the main purpose of feedback. The flow of information from top, from bottom to top, top to bottom, so that now it can help us to implement our plans. It helps us to execute what we had planned to do from the very beginning. That's why we need strategy evaluation. Anyone with a question so far? Any question so far before we proceed? Any question? And our class rep? Can you send me again that link to my WhatsApp? The one you have sent me is not working. The link you have sent me is not working. Can you send it again? I've tried to click on it and it's not working, eh? Anne. Let us proceed. We are still on strategy evaluation. Let us look at performance, how to measure the performance of our strategies. Are our strategic plans working? How do we measure if what we plan to implement is working? A moment. Okay. Okay, thank you, Anne. Thank you. Let us now look how to measure our strategic plans and the progress. How do we measure if what we planned to do is actually working? Performance. For the assessment of performance, we can use several tools such as determination of net profit. This is the most simple way of measuring if our objectives and our strategic plans are giving us results. The determination of net profits. This is the most simple, basic way of measuring our performance and assessing our progress, net profit. Now, when we come up with strategic plans, our profits should increase. If this year we make 10 million shillings, that means next year that profit should increase. The profit should not remain stagnant, nor should the profit go down. Our profits should not go down or remain stagnant. Remember, we are implementing strategic managing in purchasing and supplies so that we can increase our profits year in, year out. So if the profit is not increasing, if the profit is stagnant, that means something is wrong. It means that something is very, very wrong and we are going nowhere. Something is wrong and we are going nowhere. And so we need to sit back and look at where we are doing things wrong. That is one method, the measurement of our net profits. Let us look at another way of measuring our performance. The next one is what we call return on investment. This is a bit complicated. This is an accounting concept. Return on investment. We can calculate our return on investment. As an organization, as a company, what is our return on investment? We have invested our money somewhere in a project. Has it given us back value? This is a ratio between net income and investment. This is where we compare our net income and the investment we put in place. We look at the profits we are making and the cost of the investment. How much money have we invested in a project? And how much are we getting from the investment? If you invest 100,000 in project A, how much money will you get back from that project? That is what we call return on investment. Return on investment. A high return on investment means the investment gains compared to the cost. It means the investment gives us more returns compared to our cost. We can even use this to compare the efficiency of different investments, the return on investments. We can use this to compare the efficiency of several different investments, return on investments. We can compare project A, project B, project C, and see the benefit of this project based on the income we are getting from the projects. We call that return on investments. Return on investments. That is another way of measuring our performance. Another way we can use to measure our performance The other one is what we call earning per share. Earning per share. Let us look at what this is. Earning per share. This is the monetary value of earnings per outstanding share of common stock for a company. Remember, if things are working well, if things are good, the share price of a company should increase. Our share should earn value over time. Our company shares should earn value and earn us an income over time. Earnings per share. The value of our earnings should increase year in, year out. And remember, we have spent a lot of money and resources. We have hired experts and consultants to help us come up with a strategic plan for the organization so that we can add value to the organization through increasing the value of our share. So if last year our share was 4 shillings, come this year, if our share is 10 shillings, that is good for business. That is good for business. But now if our share was 4 shillings last year, and this year our share is 1 shillings, it means something is wrong. Our strategic plan is not working. However, if our company share increases over time, it means our strategic plans are working. And we should maintain and improve what we are doing to continue increasing the value of the share. Like Safaricom company, the share of Safaricom keeps on increasing. Year in, year out, BAT, East Africa Breweries, it means something they are doing is good. Earning per share is calculated as a company's profit divided by the outstanding shares of its common stock. That is what we call earnings per share. The company's profit divided by the outstanding shares. And therefore, if every year we increase our profit, every year we increase our profit, it means our share will earn value every year. It means every year our share will increase in value. That is how you determine the value of a company's shares. And that is one way of measuring if our strategic plans are working or they are not working, so that we can review them and correct where we are doing things in the wrong manner. Another way of measuring our progress, let us look at another way of measuring performance. How else do we measure the performance of our strategic plans? Next is what we call cost of production. We can also look at the cost of production to determine whether our strategic plans are working or not. In the last 1 year, 2 years, have we earned the value or we are doing nothing? Let us look at the cost of production. This refers to the total cost incurred by a business to produce a specific quantity of a product or offer a service. This is where we analyze. As an organization, we might be doing manufacturing, we might be doing production as February. Also, we might also be in the service sector. What is the total cost incurred to produce our finished products as an organization, as a company? What is the total cost of doing business? We look at and measure things like labor, cost of raw materials, cost of supplies, cost of electricity, cost of transport. Remember, sometimes as an organization, we might make huge profits, but then all the profits become consumed by expenses. a lot of expenditure. And unnecessary costs and expenditures can eat up our profits, so that at the end of the day, we are left with nothing. And that will be very dangerous for our organization. So we can use that to measure if our strategic plans are working or not. Remember, one of the main objectives, most organizations always have an objective of cutting costs, to cut costs. You cannot increase profits if you are not cutting costs. You will be increasing profits and at the same time increasing expenditures and expenses. So you will be doing zero work. So last year, if your operating expenses were 5 million, then this year, if your expenses are 2 million, that's good. It means your strategic plans are working. You have reduced your operating expenses from 5 million to 2 million. But if your expenses last year were 5 million, and this year your expenses are at 10 million, or they remain 5 million, that's not good for business. That's not good for the business. It means the plans you have, it means your strategic plan is not working. There's something wrong with implementation and execution. It means the leaders you appointed are not delivering. They are not performing because you have no results. They are not giving you results. That is another way of measuring the performance of our strategic plans. And lastly, we shall look at something we call rate of employee turnover. Rate of employee turnover. This is another very important concept we use to measure the performance of our strategic plans, the rate of employee turnover. Employee turnover, this is where we look at the rate at which employees leave our organizations. As an organization, how often are you advertising the same job in a year? How long do you retain your employees? Once you bring people on board, do they work for you for 10 years or more? Or people work for your company for 1 year and then they leave for greener pastures. High employee turnover rate is not good. If you keep on advertising for the same position, year in, year out, it means something is wrong with you as a company. It means that something is wrong with you as a company. Employees are coming in at a high rate, and at the same rate, the employees are leaving the company at the same rate. That is not good. Every year, you are advertising positions, and at the same time, employees are leaving the company. That is not good for business. It means there is something you are doing wrong. You have something you are doing wrongly. The rate of employee turnover. So we use that to measure if our plans are working. Remember, if everything is good, if everything is okay in a company, but if our turnover rate is low, it means everything is okay and the strategies are working. Those are some of the strategies we use to measure and evaluate our strategies and to determine whether they are working or not. as we wind up, analyzing and measuring performance involves analyzing the variance. Here we analyze the variance. What changes have taken place for us as a company, for us as an organization? Aro, you can't hear me. Anne, 1, 2 testing. 1, 2 testing. Can you hear me? Am I loud and clear? Can the others hear me?
Yes.
Damali sako sawa, eh? Anwaria, you can also hear me, eh? Okay, Anu Mekari, can you try refreshing your page? Anu Mekari, refresh your page, eh? Anu Wairia, you want to say something? I can see your hand is up.
No, it's confirming. I'm hearing you.
Okay, thank you. Anu Mwekari, everyone can hear me. Please refresh your page. You might have a problem with your connection on your end. Refresh your page. Oh, iko sawa, eh? Iko sawa, eh? Can you see now you are okay? Mm-hmm. Oh, we also have somebody new. Eunice Gure. Good morning. Welcome to class. And we have created a WhatsApp group. I've shared the link down there. Join our WhatsApp using that link I've shared down there. Eunice. We were saying we use a variance analysis to measure the progress of our performance. Now, a variance, this is where we compare our actual performance with the set standards. We set targets. We come up with the targets. And then now we must compare what we are achieving with our actual targets. And then we must also set limits. What is acceptable and what is not acceptable. We should also come up with ways of determining what is acceptable and what is not acceptable. The positive deviation indicates a better performance, while the negative deviation indicates a shortfall in performance. That's what we call variance analysis. Variance analysis. We have our set target. Have we achieved the target? Or we have achieved more than our target? Or are we performing below our target? That is what we call variance analysis. Variance analysis. Brenda, good morning, Brenda. Brenda, good morning. Rompi, Brenda. Okay, welcome to class. Eh? We have a WhatsApp group. I've shared the link down there. Join our WhatsApp group for effective communication. And once we measure our variance, then we go to the last step, number four, taking collective action. Taking collective action. Once we identify a deviation, we should come up with a plan for collective action. If our deviation is to the negative, once we measure our deviation and we determine that it is to the negative, we should come up with collective actions to correct that deviation. We should carry out a detailed analysis of the factors responsible for such poor performance. If our performance every month, if the performance is consistently less than the desired performance, we should carry out a detailed analysis of the factors responsible for such small performance. This is what we call taking corrective action. Taking corrective action. This is the last step. We call this the strategy evaluation and feedback process. The strategy evaluation and feedback process. This is the process of measuring our performance, evaluating our performance. Number one, we did what we call fixing benchmark of performance. Number two, measuring performance. Number three, analyzing the variance. And number four, taking collective action. We started by fixing our targets. This is what we called fixing benchmarking performance. What do we want to achieve? Then we measure what we are doing. That is number two. Then number three, we compare what we are achieving with our set standards. Then number four, if our variance is negative, then we take corrective action to correct the situations and the factors that are making us to perform poorly. Remember, we want to increase our profits. We want to satisfy our customers. And if there are factors preventing us from doing so, we should identify them and come up with ways of dealing with that. We should carry out a detailed analysis of the factors responsible for our poor performance. That is what we call the process of strategy implementation. Strategy implementation process. That is the strategy implementation process. Any question? Anyone with a question? Anne Wairia, Anne Mwekari, Damaris, Eunice, Brenda. Any question? We are all okay, eh? Tutafika hapo, eh? That is the end of our lesson for today. We are looking at the strategic implementation process, the process of implementing strategies. We are done with that. Next week, we shall look at another new chapter. Enjoy your weekend. See you next week. And now we have a WhatsApp group, which will be able to mobilize the classes and communicate better in the future than before. And also talk to your classmates, those who have not yet joined us. Talk to them so that they can join our class. Okay, enjoy your weekend and have a blessed day.